Hello and welcome back to another video. Consider this electronic circuit. We are going to determine the output waveform in relation to the given input signal. As you can see, this circuit consists of one PNP transistor Q1, one NPN transistor Q2, and their biasing resistors. The input is a square wave signal and has two states, positive 10 volt and negative 10 volt. So we can study the circuit per input voltage levels. Okay, let's assume Vi equals to positive 10 volt. Then Q1 remains off because the emitter of Q1 is connected to the positive 10 volt power supply through the resistor R. And its base connected to the positive 10 volt input voltage through RB1. So there is no any voltage difference between emitter and base of Q1, and there won't be any current flowing through the emitter base junction. However, with Vi equals to positive 10 volt, transistor Q2 will turn on because it is forward biased and its base emitter junction will conduct since the emitter of Q2 is connected to ground, and there will be a current flowing through the RB2 resistor. We will call this current IB2. Let's calculate IB2. Now, by knowing IB2 and transistor current gain, which also known beta, in this case 100, we can calculate the current flowing through the collector of Q2. So we can write with a close look at the circuit, we can see that the collector current also passes through the resistor R. Remember, in this case, there is no current flowing through the emitter of Q1. No current here. And the collector current also passes through the R. Now, by a simple KVL, we can find output voltage due to Vi equal to positive 10 volt. So VO equals VCC minus IC2, also IR, times multiply to R is equal to Before we continue, please subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. Your support will help this channel to grow and encourage me to create more videos. Thank you, and now back to the video. Now we consider VI equals to negative 10 volts. In this case, transistor Q2 is reverse biased, so it will turn off and no current at its collector. However, transistor Q1 will turn on because now it is forward biased and its emitter base junction will conduct and there will be a current flowing through its emitter and base. Now by a simple KVL from the supply voltage, resistor R, emitter base junction, RB1 and input voltage, we can determine the base current or emitter current depending how you write the KVL expression. So we will have now, since we know the base current, we can calculate the emitter's current. Again here, the output voltage can be calculated by subtracting the supply voltage from the voltage at resistor R terminals. So now we can draw the output voltage waveform in relation to the input signal. If you enjoyed the video and found this channel helpful, please like, subscribe, and share your thoughts under the comments. I appreciate your support. Thank you.